brought to you by Sunbeam, the best electric shavers made. Makers of the new Sunbeam Rollmaster electric shaver with automatic self-adjusting rollers that automatically adjust to your face and beard. Now, let's all play What's My Line?
And now let's meet our award-winning panel of What's My Line. First, the popular columnist whose voice of Broadway appears in papers coast to coast, Miss Dorothy Kilgallen.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. On my left, it's a great pleasure to introduce a wonderful comedian who is appearing here in New York at the Blue Angel, but is known throughout the country for his marvelous records, which are bestsellers, inside and outside, Shelley Berman.
And on my left, the gracious lady whose current portrait appears in Look magazine, Arlene Francis.
And now the distinguished publisher of Random House and columnist for This Week magazine, Mr. Bennett, sir.
And here's our ubiquitous, pixie-like panel moderator, John Charles Daly.
Well, I may have a bit of the pixie in me after all. We'll let the panel find out how much pixie there is in all of us tonight. We've got some very interesting occupations, and we trust the panel will have some fun with them and with us. We'll also have a famous mystery guest before the panel a little bit later in the show, and we'll meet our first challenger after... Now let's meet our first challenger. Would you come in and sign in, please? Juanita? Kid? Stout, right?
And is it Miss or Mrs. Stout?
Mrs.
Mrs. Stout, and where are you from?
I'm from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania.
Philadelphia, Pennsylvania.
That's right.
Well, you see, you have some moral support with you tonight.
Wonderful, wonderful.
Mrs. Stout, our panel. Panel, Mrs. Stout, will you join me over here, please?
Yes.
Tell me, are you familiar with our scorekeeping
system?
Yes,
I am.
All right, I have to ask the question because otherwise I'd have to explain. It's very complex. After I took my doctorate, I finally began to understand it myself. But since you understand it already, we'll let everybody know exactly what your line is. All right, panel, we can tell you that Mrs. Stout is salaried. And then let's begin the general questioning with Dorothy Kilgallen.
Oh, Mrs. Stout, do you work for a profit-making organization?
No.
That's one down and nine to go. Shelley Burnett.
Is there a product involved in what you do?
No.
That's two down and eight to go, Miss Francis.
Do you work for any branch of a government?
Yes.
Is it our government?
Yes.
Is it state government?
No.
That's three down and seven to go, Mr. Sir.
Well, now, Mrs. Stout, you said our government. By that, do you mean the federal government?
No.
No. Four down and six to go, Mr. Kilgallen.
Our government?
No, the word our there, we accepted to mean the American government, some form of American government as opposed to Canadian, Mexican, United Kingdom, French, German, Algerian, or Hong Kong. Four down and six to go, Mr. Kilgallen.
Mrs. Stout, do you then work for a local government?
No.
Well, now, wait a minute, just a moment. I'll have to have a small time.
Yes.
I hesitate to use the word below, and I don't mean this in a derogatory sense, but just for clarification, is it something below the state level?
Yes.
Subdividing the state of Pennsylvania.
Yes.
Do you have something to do with something in Pennsylvania?
Something
in Pennsylvania?
Yes.
Is your office appointive rather than elective?
Both.
Now, un momento, please.
Yes.
Dorothy, I think here, with your permission, the office is basically elective. There is an appointment procedure which would apply only in times of emergency, so it is not an appointive office in the term that we normally would use. With your permission, therefore, readily granted, five down and five to go, Mr. Burke.
Would I be correct in assuming you're not a spy from... You work for a branch, and we have established that you work for a branch of the government in Pennsylvania, and it is local. Is that correct?
Yes.
Do you work within an enclosure?
Yes.
A building? Would it be an office building?
Yes.
Would it be an office building in a capital city?
No.
That makes it six down and four to go, Miss Francis.
Is there much paperwork associated with what you do?
Yes.
Does a lot of paper go through your hands, coming and going?
Yes.
Would you have anything to do with communication in any way?
No.
That's seven down and three to go, Mr. Cerf.
Mrs. Stout, the paper that does go through your hands, is that ever in the form of legal tender?
Is
that
it ever
money.
In the form of legal tender?
Money, is money involved in any of your machinations?
No.
No,
no money?
Eight down and two to go, Miss Gilgal.
Mrs. Stout, would it be possible for a man to do what you do?
Yes.
Would it be unremarkable if a man did what you did?
No.
Well, yes, it would. Would it be unremarkable?
Oh, yes. Mm-hmm.
Would you say there are more men doing what you do than women?
Yes.
Is there anything at all that has to do with the law or the judiciary connected with what you do?
Yes.
Do you have to do with law enforcement rather than interpretation?
No.
That's nine down and one to go, Mr. Bowman.
Is your work in the interpretation, then, of the law?
Yes.
Are you,
Say it.
Are you a trained... Have you passed the bar?
Yes.
Haven't we all?
But not many, are you?
Speak for yourself, honey. You are, then, an attorney. Is that correct? Perhaps
no.
Not functioning as an attorney right now, but you are an attorney.
Well, he's...
You are a lawyer.
You may not be functioning as an attorney, but you are...
Are you a judge?
Yes. Hey, that's very good. Judge Juanita Kidd Stout, who is in the magistrate's court, I believe.
No, municipal court.
The municipal court, but you are known as a magistrate?
No, it's the first court of record. The magistrate's court is not a court of record.
It's not a court of record.
This is a court of record.
Court of record.
That's right.
I see. And the interesting thing is that Mrs. Stout, who was originally appointed to fill an unexpired term, ran in these previous elections in Philadelphia, mm-hmm. and came through with the biggest plurality in the city of Philadelphia, I think, except only your mayor.
Later.
Yeah.
Well,
mayor,
congratulations.
It's a very fine book. Thank you very much for being our guest. And by the way, Judge Stout asked me to make sure that it was clear to everyone that, well, we'll flip the other one over. What did come out of our scoring system tonight is to go to the United Cerebral Palsy Fund of Philadelphia and its environs. And that gives me another clue. As you know, we're living in a time when we're coming more and more to understand the value of that old, old adage, an ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure. Well, this is Diabetes Week, and it has nothing to do with raising funds at all. It has to do with something that's, I think, more important. The American Diabetes Association urges you to be alert to the fact that any one of us may have diabetes, and if we have any sense at all, we'll find out about it. What we need to do is to be sure and be tested. So call your doctor during this week. Your local Diabetes Association or Medical Society will give you all the details, but it's simply a request, and I think a very reasonable request, that you use some good sense. So that's all I have to say on that point. Let's have another challenger. May we have a new contestant sign in, please? Come in. Wherever you are.
Right there, please.
Robert, C. Wishart. Right, sir? Mr. Wishart, where are you from?
Conway, Massachusetts.
Conway, Massachusetts.
That's right.
Oh, that's fine. Mr. Wishart, may I present the panel? Panel, may I present Mr. Wishart? Will you join me over here, please, sir?
You know how we keep score.
Yes, sir.
All righty. We let the folks in the audience here in the theater, those looking in at home, know exactly what your line is. Panel, Mr. Wishart is salaried, and let's begin the general questioning with Arlene Francis.
Well, Mr. Wishart, Conway is big outdoor country. Does your profession have anything to do with the outdoors?
Yes.
It has a relationship that may be somewhat tenuous, but certainly we could evolve one if necessary.
Well, I gather from that that Mr. Wishart could also work indoors?
Yes.
Do people come to you for your services?
To the degree that a service is involved, I don't think we could describe them as coming to you for your services, do you?
No.
That's very good. One down and nine to go, Mr. Sir.
Mr. Wishart, I wonder if Arlene is mixing up Conway, Massachusetts and Conway, New Hampshire. Where is Conway, Massachusetts? Would you tell us?
No.
In relation to, how far is it from Boston?
It's in the northwest corner of Massachusetts.
Northwest corner. It is the rural
they
part.
Have snow there.
It's near Griswoldville. That will clarify it for you.
Oh, no, it doesn't.
Griswoldville, lovely town. Mr. Wishart, is there a product involved in what you do?
Yes, sir.
Is it a product that is used by both men and women?
Yes.
Would it involve in any way animals?
Yes.
It would. Is your work connected in some way with animals?
Well, here again, there is a relationship, I think, between the work that Mr. Wishart does and animals. It's somewhat indirect and tenuous, but we could evolve one if we needed to, couldn't we? There you are.
You're so helpful, John. Do you work for a profit-making organization, Mr. Wishart?
Yes.
Does this company manufacture the product in which you deal?
Yes.
Is the product made up in any part of metal?
No.
That is two down and eight to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Mr. Wishart, is this tenuous product partially or wholly animal?
Neither.
No. And the relationship is tenuous, not the product. That makes it three down and seven to go, Mr. Berman.
When you do your job, sir, do you, or when you, you know, carry your product... Oh, tell me this. Can you carry your product?
Can you carry it?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Could I carry your product?
Yes.
I'd like to find out a little bit about the consistency of this product. If your product fell out of a window and fell on me, would it kill me?
Probably not.
Hmm?
Probably not.
Probably not, although much would depend here on the height from which it was.
Well, if it fell out of a low window,
you,
is what I meant.
How good the aim was, what you were wearing at the time, you know, all sorts of things. But probably not.
All right. Now, do you, sir, come into contact with animals?
No.
That makes it four down and six to go, Miss Francis.
Is there anything about your product that an animal would not like?
No.
Hey, what'd you say? Wait a minute, we gotta have a small cut. We don't want to mislead you here.
Yes, you do, John.
Yes, we do. I mean, no, we don't. It's very hard, you know, to judge the likes or the dislikes of an animal.
Maybe I didn't put it quite right. Maybe if I said something like, is it anything that might in any way restrain an animal or hold an animal in or back?
That simplifies it. That's five down and five to go, Mr. Sir.
Mr. Wishart, Might your product be either worn or consumed?
Yes.
Which is it?
No, wait a minute. Which is it? I put it in the back of my head. You have got a yes to the question, may it be worn or consumed. We accept here, when you use the word consumed, that you are speaking of used up. Right. Mm-hmm.
All right, well, I'll use the first part. May your product ever be worn in some way?
No.
That makes it 6-4 to go, Miss Kilgall.
May I assume from the misleading line of answers to Mr. Cerf's question that this is not eaten?
Dorothy, are you accusing me of obfuscation?
No, John.
Heavenly
only
days,
inadvertent obfuscation. But anyway, would you say that this is never eaten by a person or an animal? May we rule that out?
Yes, ma'am.
Is it never drunk by a person or an animal?
Never.
It does not enter the mouth in any way?
No.
I mean, for any good purpose.
Well, that opens a whole lot of new prospects as far as I'm concerned.
No, it doesn't, because I'm going to close it. Could anyone on this panel wear this particular thing?
Don't look at me. Answer the woman. Well, actually, I don't think the... I tell you what.
False teeth.
You're not very close. I thought you were going to get to it, but you're off on a sticky wicket. So we'll tell you what it is and throw the cards all over. And it's loads of fun. Mr. Wishart makes horse liniment.
Makes horse liniment?
Horse liniment. And I tell you don't wear it, but I guess you put it on. You know, it's one of those things that can confuse you. And it surprised me, Mr. Wishart, actually. I didn't know it was still manufactured. It's manufactured in Griswoldville, right? Griswoldville by the Kendall Company. And the thing that's real fun about it, Mr. Wishart says there are still folks, because I remember it from my childhood, you know, when you had a sprain or a spavin, and I got my spavins early, you rubbed some horse liniment on it. And there are still folks who use it.
Excuse me, but I think Absorbine Junior was a derivative of horse liniment originally, because on the first bottles of Absorbine Junior were the initials PDF, because it was discovered by the stupid boy in the family, and the PDF, Absorbine Junior made a fortune for this young man, and PDF stood for Papa's Damn Fool.
For one thing.
Thank you, sir, no.
Oh, I'm just a fund of information like that. Very good for horses.
Well, I don't think Mr. Wishart will mind if I share this little irony with you. Arlene, Absorbine is the Kendall Company's biggest competitor.
Well, I want to make the statement right now that this show is not rigged.
Say Kendall's counter-irritant in return.
Yes, indeed. What is Kendall's counter-irritant?
Well, Kendall's counter-irritant is the name of the product.
Oh, really?
There we are.
What's your product called? Absorbine Senior?
Oh, Bennett. No, it's called... Actually, the one that Mr. Wishart works is called horse liniment.
It's horse liniment?
Yeah. We'll get you some.
Well,
Thank you very much, Mr. Wishart. Nice to have you with us. Now we meet tonight's mystery guest in just a moment, but first, here is a message from our sponsor. We come to the special feature of our program, the appearance of our mystery celebrity, for which I've asked my friends on the panel, as always, to blindfold themselves. Blindfolds in place, panel?
Yes, sir.
Good. Will you come in, mystery challenger, and sign in, please? As you know, in the case of our mystery challenger, we go to a different form of questioning. You ask questions one at a time, in turn, moving clockwise, and we'll begin it all with Bennett, sir.
Well, if and when your name appears in the paper, would it be more likely to appear in the amusement section than, let's say, the sports section or the financial section or the book page?
Yes. Miss Kilgallen?
Have you been in Canada recently?
No.
One down and nine to go, Mr. Berman.
Are you appearing at present in New York in any form of entertainment?
No.
Two down and eight to go, Miss Francis.
Now, have you been in pictures?
Yes.
Mr. Sir?
Are you going to appear in New York in the near future in some form of entertainment? I mean in the very near future, within the next 2 weeks.
No.
That makes it three down and seven to go, Miss Kilgallen.
Are you over 6'1"?
No.
That's four down and six to go, Shelley Berman.
Are you in the movies?
Yes.
Actually, Shelley, you get another question because I believe that was indirectly elicited by an earlier question.
Well, are you a leading man?
I didn't hear.
Are you a leading man?
Yes.
Miss Francis?
Well, there was a great deal of screaming and shouting when you came in. Do you have great appeal for the young? Because there
yes.
was young screaming and shouting.
The answer to that was yes, Mr. Sir.
Do you ever sing in the course of your appearances on the motion picture screen?
Yes.
Oh, are you Tab Hunter?
What'd you say, Dorothy?
Well, I'm sorry I said it. Are you Tab Hunter?
Now, that's a no.
No.
Five down and five to go, Shelley Burton.
I'm afraid to open my mouth. You sing. Is that what you're primarily popular for, your singing, or is it... is singing your primary talent?
Yes.
The last time Ricky Wood Nelson was here, I said, are you Fabian? Now I will ask you. Not are you Ricky Nelson, but are you Fabian?
Yes.
Well, that was good guessing.
Ricky Nelson, I did the same thing that you did with Tab Hunter. I said, you're Fabian, because that's when they all squeal like that. And so you've had two plugs for the price of one now, Mr. Fabian.
Well, actually, you have, as you every right to claim, to a great and very loyal and very enthusiastic and using it in its proper way, loud following among the young folk.
Yes.
But since you started making movies, I understand that you and a dean, shall we say, in your
That's
field,
right.
Bing Crosby, made a movie together.
Will be.
With it. You're going to make one together,
yeah,
right?
It starts in January, yes.
And I understand he goes back to college, and I was wondering if you'd tell us where you go if he goes back to college.
Well, I'm right in college at the time, and we sort of room together. That's how it winds up.
You mean Bing is back there getting his college degree?
That's right, yes.
Hi, Don.
What happened in all these intervening years?
May I ask a question, John?
Yeah.
I'm puzzled by this name, Fabian. Is that your real name?
Yes, that's
your first name or your
last
name?
My real first name, yes.
What's your last name?
Forte, F-O-R-T-E.
Oh, how appropriate.
Fabian Forte.
Oh, that's wonderful.
Fortissimo.
Well, life begins for you at Forte.
Bennett, would you mind leaving the room?
And that is what is called stunned silence. Well, Fabian, it's been very nice to have you with us.
Thank you very much.
We certainly share with pleasure the great success you have, and I trust that your career keeps on going skyward.
Well, thank you
very
much.
Good to have you
here.
Nice to have you. What's my line? Say goodnight to me. Well, we'll be back after this word from our sponsor. I'm a little bit uncertain about many things tonight, which is my 40, and I'm not sure how much time we've got left, so I'll take the big dive and say it's been a lot of fun having you with us, Shelley Berman, and good night, Miss Dorothy Kilgallen.
Good night, John. Good night, Shelley.
Good night, Dorothy, and good night, Arlene.
Did you have fun?
Oh, yes, I had a lot of fun. I wasn't as scared as I thought I'd be.
You were very good, too. Good night, Bennett.
Good night, John Charles.
John. Is that Charles, all you're going to say, Bennett?
John Charles Patrick Crowan Daly.
Hooray! He got it right.
Is that right?
Got it right. That's exactly right. Now, Bennett has one more test to pass. How do you spell Crowan?
C-R-O-N-E.
I asked for that, and I got it, and thank you for being with us on What's My Line. Good night.
Transportation for contestants on What's My Line is arranged by United Airlines. What's My Line is a CBS Television Network production in association with Mark Goodson and Bill Trotman. This is Hal Sims speaking.